Homeboys know that everything happens on the boulevard, and the boulevard happens at night.
Hola amigos, yo soy Fanny Girl con Fanny Girl Projections. Pues ahora me encuentro aquí con este actor súper talentoso que ya tiene una larga trayectoria. Ya ha estado en dos películas que son súper clásicas como Boulevard Nights y American Me. Y él es the one and only Mr. Danny De La Paz, better known as Chuco and Big Puppet. How are you doing? Welcome to Arizona.
Very well, thank you. Thank you for having me. I enjoy talking about my career with people like yourself, and I'm very happy to be here where there's a lot of fans that show me a lot of love.
How has Arizona treated you so far? You've been here for a week, you were telling me.
Yeah, I've been here in Tucson for a week, but I haven't been to Arizona for about 2 years. But I always enjoy coming here because there's a lot of fans and a lot of love for the movies. And so I always like to, if I get the chance to come and connect with the fans, I like it.
So let's take you back to 1978. We're going to talk about Boulevard Nights.
Okay, 1978 in the summer was when we made Boulevard Nights. I think we started in July, and we went all the way through October, middle of October, until we finished filming. Yeah, that was the 40 years ago when we filmed it.
It's been 40 years already. Let's talk about your role as Chuco.
Well, at the time, that was a part that a lot of people wanted to play. A lot of actors wanted to play that part because, you know, it was a big role. And it was a good opportunity for an actor. And but nobody had any idea that 40 years later, we would still be talking about that movie. So it's been 40 years now. In March, it's going to be the 40th anniversary of the release of the movie.
It's a classic. Let me tell you, I still watch that movie. And I know a lot of the new generations, younger generations, they're still watching that movie.
Yeah, I'm very grateful for that because, you know, it's amazing that the movie has lasted so long and it's been passed down from generation to generation. So I'm very, very grateful for that. It's great.
When did you find out that you wanted to be an actor? I know you were very young. You were in high school when you got your first shot, right?
I was 14 years old in my freshman year of high school. And I got involved in the drama department. We had a very young teacher. She was like 28 years old, and she was very energetic, and she recognized that I had talent, and she sort of helped me to realize that, you know, that I could do something with acting. And that's when it started, when I was 14. I kind of knew at that time, you know, you do a play and then people come and see it, and then afterwards they would want to come and talk to me when the play was over. But, you know, people that I didn't know. So I thought, wow, people seem to like me up on the stage. Maybe I should do this for a living, you know.
After you see the success of this movie, did you ever imagine you were going to land another role in a big classic movie?
Actually, when I was younger, we were talking about American Me on the set of Boulevard Nights because it was a script that was going around. People were reading it. But nobody had produced it yet. No studio had agreed to make it. So at that time, because I was young, I was looking forward to playing Little Puppet. But then many years passed, and the 70s went, and the 80s came and went.
And you ended up playing Big Puppet.
Finally, it was the early 90s, and I ended up playing the older brother instead of the younger brother. But I was grateful to be in it, because that's another one that became a classic, you know?
You were asked by Edward James Olmos to play this part.
Well, he handpicked everybody that was in the film. They were all there because of him. It was his, he was co-produced it, he co-wrote it with the writer of Boulevard Nights and some other people too, and he was the director. So it was really his baby, his project, you know, and he was very, very particular about the people that were in the film. All the actors were pretty much handpicked by him.
Did you ever imagine you were going to be on the big screens of Hollywood?
You know, when I started being in plays and doing theater, I never imagined that. No. Well, it wasn't until I got to be a little older, like my senior year of high school, that I started to think, "Oh, maybe I could be on television or something," you know? I don't know. I didn't know what the possibilities were. But I knew that on television there was a lot of young people like myself, some people of color too. So I thought, well, maybe I could squeeze into a TV series or something, you know. But I never did really fit into the whole television mode. I usually only got work in films. Maybe I was too serious for TV, I don't know.
I wasn't goofy enough.
I imagine it was harder back then than it is now to be an actor. Especially now we have social media. We have a lot more ways of, you know, of promoting yourself.
Exactly. There's more opportunities. You could have your own YouTube channel. Look at some of these people that have their YouTube channels. They're brilliant. Millions of followers, and you know, they get paid on YouTube. I mean, it's great. We didn't have that back when I was starting. So in some ways it's harder to be an actor today because maybe there's so many more people doing it. But in other ways there's more opportunities, more chances for you to show your talent or, you know, exhibit what it is you do, whether it's comedy or drama, or some people like to have talk shows, you know. But I love it. There's a lot of YouTube channels I watch. I subscribe to it. I watch them regularly because I really enjoy the content and the people that host the shows and the ideas. Yeah, I love the different perspectives. I really enjoy YouTube. I must confess that I don't watch much television, to be honest. But I'm a YouTube junkie. I got to admit, I really am. When I go to bed at night, it's just me and YouTube, baby. That's all.
That's it, right?
That's it, pretty much.
Playing the role of Chuco and Big Puppet, how did that change your life?
You know, the night before Boulevard Nights opened, it was Thursday night, March the 22nd of 1979. The next day on Friday, the movie was going to open in theaters all across the country. Well, that up to that Thursday night, that was one life that I had. And when I got up on Friday morning, the 23rd of March, 1979, my new life began. So the old life I had was gone forever. It was never going to come back. I didn't know it at the time. But when I woke up on Friday morning and Boulevard Nights opened and they started playing it in theaters, that was the beginning of a whole new life.
When they tell you you're going to play this role, you're going to be involved in gangs, what did you think?
Well, imagine me not being raised, you know, in gangs.
You played it so good.
Yeah, I didn't even know what the words in the script meant. Really? Like vato and firme. Firme, I saw firme in the script and I thought, what is that, firme? Yeah, I didn't know what it was, you know? Vato and all these different words, esse. I didn't know Jack, no, I wasn't. But the inside of the character, the way the character felt, his loneliness, his feeling of isolated, you know, he didn't have a dad, and there's certain things he didn't want to talk to his mom about, you know, because he's 16. His older brother was like a father figure, but now his older brother had a girlfriend, and he was busy to get married, and no one had any time for Chuco. So he was kind of on his own. That I related to. So the inside of him, I had that down. It was the outside, the way he dressed, the way he talked, the way he wore his hair. That stuff I had to learn, the way he spoke.
How long did it take you to adapt to this role?
Well, it was the homeboys, the real homeboys from the real gangs in East LA that they hired to be with me in the VGV gang.
Really?
They're the ones that taught me, really. They're the ones that shared their life with me and told me what it was like to be who they were and what they did and how they dress. And they took me to the barber and they cut my hair off and they showed me how to walk and how to talk. And it was just like college, you know, Cholo college.
Did your perspective change about everything after this movies?
Yeah, it did. I got more in touch with my Chicano culture. I knew I was Chicano, but I didn't really understand what it meant until I made Boulevard Nights. And having to be this person for 10 weeks while we shot the film and to be in that environment, it changed me forever. It made me see life from another point of view. And that's when I learned that, you know, if you just look at things from your point of view, that's okay, I guess. But if you can flip around and see it from other points of view, you get more of an honest picture of how things really are. And it taught me not to be so prejudiced, because I had my own prejudices, you know, about gangs and stuff like that too, I guess, when I was younger, you know.
Danny, let's talk about Jesse Borrego, better known as Crucito. Yes. And about your guys' project, Crazy Vatos.
Well, next year is the 10th anniversary of our business, Crazy Vatos Emporium. We had a store that we opened up in San Antonio back in 2009, and it was open for about a little over a year before we closed it down, but it was a great experience. And we've kept the company going, and we still have things that we offer, that we have online and stuff like that. But it's really about our culture. The whole idea of Crazy Vatos Emporium is to promote Chicano culture through the arts. So, and Jesse's always been about that, always. And I'm about it too. So, and the two of us are very good friends. So it just only made sense for us to come together and form the company.
Very talented people, that's for sure. I also heard you have something going on Netflix.
Well, I'm producing a new documentary, which I've been working on for 3 years. And we're hoping to air it on Netflix when we're done with it. We'll be done in 2019. This coming year will be finished. It's about a Latino man that passed away about 4 years ago at the age of 90. And it's basically his life story. He was 90 years old. So he's a guy that nobody knows who he is, but his story is really amazing. And we wanted to share his story with people. So we made a documentary about it. It's called The Life and Times of Jose Saria. And it takes place in San Francisco.
What advice can you give the young kids? The ones that are getting in trouble, the ones that are getting involved with drugs.
You know, when I look back on when I was young, I think that I found something that I loved to do. And that's what changed my life. That's the direction I went in, was follow that. Follow what you love to do. Follow your passion. Follow your heart. Figure out what it is you like to do, what you want to become, or what it is you want to do, express, or whatever, and follow that. That's the thing. Follow your dreams, man. You know, life is short. Why waste your time futzing around with making other people happy, you know? I could have been doing something that I didn't want to do, and I don't want to get up in the morning and go somewhere that I don't want to go just to make money, you know? Hate my job and hate myself. And not be like a happy person, you know? Why not be happy?
What advice can you give them as Chuco and Big Puppet?
Well, you know, those characters, I hope that they can learn from those characters. I always ask parents, when your kid is 7, 8, 9 years old, show them Boulevard Nights. And after you watch the movie, talk about Chuco. Talk about the choices that Chuco made. Talk about the consequences of those choices. Use the movie as a teaching tool for your kids. Both Boulevard Nights when they're younger, and American Me when they get a little bit older. And if that's really why Edward James almost made those films. He wanted them to be teaching tools. He wanted to put the message out. Look, we need to look at this, not sweep it under the rug. We need to look this in the eye. If we're ever going to fix or change this, we need to be honest about it. And that's really why he made American Me. And I think that parents can use those films as teaching tools, and those movies were worth making then. If they can change somebody's life. And a lot of people have told me that they've seen movies like that and said, you know what, it did make me change my life. I start to see things in a different way once I saw that film.
Now they see the real person, the real Chuco.
Yeah, but, you know, sometimes people are disappointed when they meet you in person and you don't turn out to be like the character. You know, they're like, oh my God, I thought you were a hard-ass troller, you know. I hate to disappoint them, but hey, I'm an actor, what can I say, you know?
So what advice can you give the young kids that are starting their career as actors, you know? Now it's, like we just mentioned, it's easier now than it used to be when you started.
I would say, you know, take advantage of this new technology, of all the media, the YouTube, you know, channel. Start a channel. If you're an actor and you want to do and you want to develop your skills as an actor, start doing scenes on YouTube with other actors and just do them for the fun of it and let other people watch your channel and see you develop as you go along in time. We never had that kind of an opportunity before, you know? There's all kinds of people that have comedy shows on YouTube. Man, they're getting offers to be in TV series and to be in movies just from their work on YouTube. So I would say take advantage of the media that's there for you today that wasn't there when I was young. Take advantage of it. It's there. It's free. Can't beat the price. Yeah, these days there is, yeah.
So where can people follow your work and know about your new upcoming projects?
Well, I have a Facebook page, which is under my name, Danny De La Paz.
I just requested you.
Okay, I'll have to go through and check that out. And I'm also on Instagram at Big Puppet, one word.
And I have an eBay page too. If people want to, you know, look at the merch and stuff, just go Danny De La Paz eBay, and you'll see all the things that I have that I mail out. You know, practically to the post office now, you know.
¿Algún mensaje que le quieras mandar a todos tus fans que te están viendo?
Yes, I love my fans so much. I tell you this, I have the best fans in the world, the most loving, kind, wonderful people. They write me messages on Facebook from all over the country, from all over the world, really. And the things they say, sometimes they bring tears to my eyes. It's so beautiful. I think the stories they share about their childhood and, you know, when they saw the movies and what it means to them and how they grew up with those films, I don't know what to say. I'm so humbled when I read those stories. So I guess I would have to say thank you to all the beautiful, beautiful fans out there for all these years. Can you imagine 40 years? But especially recently, yes, thank you for your support. Thank you for your love. And I hope that I'm always able to show it back to you if we get to meet in person or if I reply to you through social media.
I really want to thank you for your time. I am Fanny with Fanny Girl Productions.